Hi, Michael. My name is Demi. In the recent past, you've advocated for the outright eradication of transgenderism from public life with the claim that the supposed right of confused people to pretend to be the opposite sex necessarily infringes on your right to distinguish between men and women. I'm standing here now, a biological male wearing a dress with a pair of leggings. Do you sincerely believe that I should be subject to punitive justice on the basis of what I'm wearing? And if so, are you willing to turn yourself in for wearing women's panties in your gay college film?
Well, I'll take those questions in order, I guess. The first one, I would encourage you to behave as a man, is what I would do. Because you are a man, and I don't know how exactly you came to the point where you think you're a woman or very much would like to be a woman, but you aren't. And I don't think anyone who is affirming your delusion is helping you. I don't think that they're actually an ally of yours. I think they're lying to you, and I think it's very disrespectful, and I think it will not lead to your flourishing. I think it will only immiserate you. And so you might hate me for telling you the truth, but I think the truth will set you free. And furthermore, your masquerading as a woman does infringe on the legitimate rights of other people, the rights of women to have their own bathrooms. I don't know if you're an athlete. I'm not much of an athlete myself, but the rights of women to have their own sports leagues and the like. That is not something that you have a right to do, no matter how sincerely you believe the fantasy that you are a woman. As to that Yale thesis film, this thing dogs me. You know, back in my wayward youth, I was never a transvestite or a homosexual or anything, but I was something even more morally suspect. I was a professional actor. And I played 200 roles, I would estimate, in my acting career. Soldiers, football players, real macho guys. But you play one half gay guy in a Yale thesis film one time, it's all anybody wants to talk about. And by the way, I don't remember the exact wardrobe from that undergraduate thesis film, but I think it was male attire, but it was a bit risque. There's no question about that. The only further thing I will say about that Yale undergraduate thesis film, that is the most heterosexual thing that has ever been produced at Yale University, okay? So in the land of the blind, I guess, the one-eyed man is king. In any case, I think your second question was a little bit more of a joke. Your first question, it seems like a sincere question, and my answer to you is sincere. I'm happy to answer any more questions you have, but I'm not going to lie to you, and I think the people who are continuing to lie to you about so basic an aspect of your nature and the rights that you have in political society are not doing you any favors at all.
So having yearned for the days when it was illegal to cross-dress in San Francisco, I'm just very curious why you're so comfortable, you know, wearing drag in these films. It's a really silly.
Sure, you know, I was an actor and I wore silly costumes. I don't know what to tell you. If you have a sincere question about the issue or my stance on transgenderism or, you know, any advice that you might be seeking, I'm happy to do it. But if you merely want to say that Yale is a bit of a queer school and, you know, I was in a student film, I guess I was, and I was basically the most macho guy at that school. What does that tell you about Yale University?
When you harp on your right to distinguish between men and women, are you afraid that you're going to be attracted to trans women?
I'm not.
You sir? Are you positive?
Say it again. I didn't hear the second part.
Then why is it that you harp on your right to distinguish between men and women? If you can always tell, why is it so hard?
Well, because it's not even merely that you're putting on a dress. It's that you and people who identify as transgender are infringing upon rights and spaces that properly belong to women, and you have no right to do that. And so when you ask me, why do you care about this issue? And by the way, it's not just me. It's like the vast majority of voters who care about this. The reason is because we live in society and we have political rights, and also because we care for the truth. And the very fact that this always happens with the sexual revolutionaries, they always say, you know, if you oppose, if you don't agree with the idea that a man can secretly be a woman, then maybe you're a transgender or something. I think the implication is quite clear, which is that you recognize there's something obviously disordered about this identity. That's why in your attempt to insult people who are pointing out the truth, you're accusing them of that very same thing. But that inclination, that impulse to see that as a disorder should be instructive to you, and I think it could help you if you would allow yourself, not to just cast it on someone else, but to look in the mirror.
If you ever want to explore your true self, my Instagram is at demigloom, D-E-M-I-G-L-O-O-M.
Thank you so much. I'll have to take a rain check.